morning, everyone. Today is Saturday, and we're going for breakfast at this beef noodle restaurant. So it's around 1.2 kilometers away from the hotel. And so yeah, let's go.
So we visited Old Charot Restaurant in Yawarat Road for the morning breakfast. It took us a good 15-minute walk to the restaurant from our hotel. When we arrived, there was no queue, but the shop was already seated with many locals who probably worked nearby. It seems to be run by a middle-aged Chinese chef who personally cooks every bowl of noodle himself. We placed our order and took a seat. There is no English menu, and his command of English is limited. While waiting, I simply just explored the sauces they have on the table that could be paired with our noodle soup later. The noodle comes with thick basmati, boiled beef chunks, beef strips, and beef balls. I simply just added some chili flakes on my soup as well to add flavor to my soup broth. Let me just try the chayan first before starting on my meal. Here on the wall, I noticed that they got their Michelin in both 2020 and 2021. Breakfast costed us 170 baht for 2 persons, but it wasn't that satisfying. The broth was bland and the beef weren't that special. It was tough without much beefiness taste to it. The tea itself was also bland. Therefore, we headed to a nearby cafe for coffee and chocolate croissant instead. I must say, this cafe is uniquely designed, made modern from a barbar style home or shop house. They collect many vintage items as well. Look at this fortune table. You can toss a coin, make a wish on this table itself, and water flows out from the table all the way to the pond outside. Quite unique, isn't it? This meal at the roof cafe costed us 258 baht. After many days of flagging for taxis, we decided to try the local bus instead. The bus stop was just outside of our hotel. We took the pink bus, headed for Phuket Central Mall, and it only costed us 15 baht each. It was quite easy to navigate the bus system in Phuket. Compared that to a taxi, one way would have costed us 250 to 300 baht to Phuket Central. We arrived at the mall after 1 hour in the bus. Entering the mall felt so good because the heat outside was extremely hot. Personally, I think this mall had quite great standards and comparable to the malls in Singapore, or maybe even better. It carried many international brands and nice international restaurants too for tourists. It also had a really big supermarket and grocer as well.
Today we decided to come to the night market for dinner. We should take a look around what the local night market is like. So far there are no tourists here, mainly locals. So yeah, let's see what we're gonna get. Maybe I'll just pack back today. Pack back to the hotel and eat. So yep, we'll show you what we got later on. Let's take a look at what they have.
That's
about the mussel and cockle.
Cockle, yeah,
I saw. This is like a
cockle.
Yeah. Oh, a lot of things. Cockle. Yeah. A lot, yeah. Hey, what's this?
Maggot.
What the hell? Oh, that's interesting.
So,
no!
We bought steamed river prawns, braised pig ears, giant cockle salad, grilled whole saba fish, grilled chicken skewers, and mama mi noodle salad. It was way too much, and the whole dinner only costed us around 300 baht. It was very worth it for so much quality food, and in fact, I think it's better than most tourist restaurants in Phuket, with the price and value-wise paid for this meal.
Okay, today should be end. Day 3, we just finished dinner at the hotel room. So, we're heading back to the hotel, shower and sleep. Tomorrow will be a quite interesting one because we'll be watching Thai boxing live. This will be our first time that we will be watching Thai boxing at the Patong Stadium. So, watch out for tomorrow. We'll have more updates. And have a good night, guys. Bye.